how you can upload a file to GitHub from your Android phone. Also, how you can delete the repository too. So let's get right into it. So to start with, we're gonna come to the three dots, that's the three lines on the left hand side. Click on it, then click on your profile name. Basically, that is your username on GitHub. Just click on it. Okay, so once it opens up, so quick one, what is a repository? A repository contains all of your project files and each file's revision history. You can discuss and manage your project work within the repository. Take note that each time you are uploading a file to GitHub, you need to create a different repository, and repository is great in sharing your code and also in debugging. Let's get back to creating a new repository. Right here, you can see repository, and at the side you can see 16. So I've created 16 repository. So we're going to come over here and click on it. So once we click on that, you can now see new. So you can now create a repository, click on it. So right here, this is where we put the name of the repository. So basically it's going to be my username slash the repository name. So you can even see the slash right here. So let's put the name, we'll call it pro. Okay, that's available. So you can see it's green, pro is available. But what if I type it in full project? So it says, your new repository will be created as project dash. You can see that's because it's telling me that, hey, I already have that name in my repository already. I mean, I've already created a repository with that name. So I can create another one again with the same name. So that's why this one has a minus at the front of the T. So if I just remove it a little, yeah. So it's going to check again, and now it's telling me that project is available. Okay, so that's good. So down here we come to description. You can write the description about the code that you're about to upload to your GitHub account. So this is going to be public. I mean, anybody can see what you are uploading. After you're uploading, they can check the code out. If you want to make it private, I think you're going to have to pay for that to make it private. Then coming down, you can see it says initialization. Initialize this repository with da da da. So right here, what's a README file? You can add a README file to your repository to tell other people why your project is useful, what they can do with your project, and how they can use it. So this is the useful information you need to pass on to anyone who's going to check out your code. Moving on. So the next one we have here, so what is gitignore? Gitignore is a text file that tells Git which file or project to ignore in your project. A local gitignore file is usually placed in the root directory of a project. You can also create a global gitignore file, and any entry in that file will be ignored in all of your Git repository. But we're gonna skip this one. So let's move on to the next one. Okay, so we have none, we're not tracking any of them. You can choose a license. So depending, right now we don't have a license. So you can choose from any of these, but I do advise that you find more information about all these license and what they mean before you choose. Okay, let's go from there. So basically now we could just, right now we're gonna click on create repository. So let's click on that. Done. We have created our repository.
Right now, if you look down, you see it says create a new repository on the command line. Now, this code you're seeing underneath is for if you're going to use a command line to create the repository that we just created using the web. Now, one of the ways you can create a repository, the other ways, because there are more than one, if you can use a IDE like a Visual Studio Code, any other IDE out there, to create a repository using these codes, or you can use the command line. But this doesn't concern us again because we have created our real repository using this web, which is much, much easier. And so if you look underneath here, it also says, or push an existing repository from the command line. So now imagine if you want to push a file to an existing repository, this code is what they're going to use. But this doesn't really concern us right now. So we're just going to go up and click on upload an existing file.
So what we need to do is click on upload an existing file, click on it. So right here, we'll click on choose your file. Click. So from here, we're going to navigate to our files where it says files. Click. Okay, so right here, we're going to be looking for our projects. So we're going to click. This is it, HTML project. Click on it. So that's the folder. Note, we can install pictures, files, but we cannot upload a whole full folder, like a folder with all the files in it to GitHub, because what we clicked on was upload files, so it's only the files we can upload. So if you are trying to upload a whole folder at once, it won't work. So you have to open that folder and click its files. And note, your files must start with index.html. Like this, if I was going to host these files, they're not going to work because the name I use first.html, I use home.html. Now, if I'm trying to host this, I'm gonna have issues, it's gonna show me a 404. So what I was going to do is I'll need to change the name to index.html, all small letters. Now, this is just to show you how to upload a file. I'm not going to show you how to host it on GitHub. Yeah, I have other videos on that. So right now, I'm just going to click on this file. Yep. So see, if I had pictures here, I would also just click on those pictures, but I don't. So I'm just gonna click open right now. And you can see down here, the file uploaded, home.html. So it says commit changes. It says add the file to upload. It says add an option extended description. So if you want, you can put a little description right here. Maybe say something like, just an example, like commit. If you want, then you can just write little description here, this is a e-commerce website, just an example. Totally, that's, this is not an e-commerce website, I just say a HTML I created. So next thing I'm going to do, you're going to click on commit. So let's click on commit. And now to view your files, just click on view. Okay, you can see now. So if I want to click on this file and go into it, I just need to click on it and see. So that is it. I have uploaded my file up to GitHub. We can go back. The next thing I'm going to show you is how you can delete the repository. Let's say you don't want the file anymore on your GitHub and you want to delete it. All you need to do is first, let's click right here. Let's move. We're going to move this option. You see this moving? Yep. Come over to settings. Okay. Then we're going to scroll all the way down, all the way down. Yep. So this is it. It says delete this repository. Once you delete a repository, there is no going back. Please be certain. So once you delete a repository, you can't bring it back. It's gone. You've lost the code, the pictures, any files in that repository is gone. And you can see you can also archive this repository, mark this repository as archive and read only. You can also do that. So right now, let's delete this repository by clicking delete. So now what I am going to do is that it says please type. So I'm going to type my name, that's my username, then slash the project name to confirm that I want it to be deleted. So let's do that. And if you take note, you can see right now I can't click on the delete repository button because I've not done what I need to do. So now let me type it, small letters, and that is Michael. Then let's put one. Then for slash, then the project name. Okay. So if you see now, I can now click on delete this project. So I'm gonna click on it. And that's it. It says your repository, Michael slash project was successfully deleted. And take note, during that time when I had the project would have been among all these repositories right here. Would have been among them. But since I've deleted it, it's no more among these repositories. So that's how you can upload a file to GitHub from your Android phone. And that's how you can also delete the files. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe. I hope this video has been helpful to you. Bye.